Okay, last week I finished up my spoil board on this thing, but before I can start making any serious chips, I gotta get a dust shoe on this thing. Let's do it. Okay, I got the dust shoe all finished, and it's really a pretty simple design. I basically used exactly what I have on my Gatton CNC over there. It works great over there, so there's no reason to reinvent the wheel. I did have to modify on this piece here. I had to modify this hole back here where it clamps, because this spindle is about 79 millimeters in diameter, and that one is 80 millimeters. So I had to shrink the hole down a little bit. But I think it's going to work good. I haven't cut these bristles at all. I'm going to leave them long like this. I'm probably going to end up making at least one or two more of these pieces with the magnets and have different lengths of brushes so I can swap them on, because I already know these are going to be too long when I'm running a 1/8 inch end mill. They work pretty good with this quarter inch end mill. And then I also run some long half-inch end mills that are pretty long, have about 2.5 inch. So even these will probably be too short. But when I run them over there on my Gatton, I have a spacer that I put in here to space this down. So I could probably utilize that on this setup as well, since it's really basically the same design. But got good strong magnets holding it on there. I don't think it's going to be slipping off or anything. So I've moved it around, make sure the hose is going to stay, and I've got it going to the same dust collector that I have hooked up my Gatton hooked up to. I've got a Y right there. I've got a, just out of camera shot here, I've got a blast gate with a little cord where I can push it up to keep it closed if I'm running the Gatton and not this one, or if I want to open it up for this one, I can pull a string, open the blast gate, and just stick a piece of hardboard on the opening over there to close it off. So I think it's going to work pretty good. So anyway, if you like this video, please subscribe and give me the thumbs up. If you want to follow along on these videos that I'm doing on the different things I'm going to make with this CNC, be sure and subscribe, and also be sure to hit the little bell so you'll get notifications when I upload a video. And if you'd like to make one of these yourself, I'm going to have the plans. Well, not really plans, but I'm going to have the VCAR files that I used on my website. All you have to do is add them to the cart. They're going to be free. There won't be anything, but you just add them to the cart, click, and then you'll get a downloadable link where you can get the VCAR files. And I'll probably throw the program files on there as well, although you might have to change something if you don't have the same tooling I do. So so anyway, be sure and check that out. And also, if you want to make one of these, I have the links for the brush, the hose clamp, the hose, the magnets. I think that's pretty much everything I use for this. They'll all be down below in the show description, so feel free to click on those and go buy some of the same stuff I'm using here. So anyway, that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll talk to you later. Thanks for watching.